Hi, welcome back to our channel. Recently, Huawei released the MateBook 13S, 14S laptops, and this 90 watt scan charger is included in the box. Today, ChargerLab will tear down this Huawei fast charger to see what's inside. It adopts fixed pins, and the plug will vary based on your location. We can see the model is HW-200450CP0. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.6 amp.And output of 5 volts 3 amp, 9 volts 3 amp, 12 volts 3 amp, 15 volts 5 amp, 20 volts 4.5 amp. It just has one USB-C and is printed with 90 watts. The length is 59mm, the width is 60mm, the thickness is 28mm, the weight is about 181 grams. So the power density is about 0.88 watts cubic centimeter. Take out ChargerLab Power Z KT002,We can see it supports Samsung 5V, 2A, DCP protocol, and QC2, QC4, FCP, SCP, PD3, PPS fast charging protocol. It also has 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 5A, 15V, 5A, 20V, 4.5 amp, and 2 PPS PDOs of 3.4 to 11V, 5A, and 3.4 to 21V, 4.5 amp. This charger can support PPS protocol, so let's see its compatibility.Use the cutting machine to cut it off. The PCB module is filled with thermal adhesives for heat dissipation and reinforcement. Then let's clean it up. The back of the PCB is equipped with an insulating plate and a heatsink, and the heatsink is wrapped with an insulating tape. Remove the heatsink, and there are another small heatsink and isolation plate on it. The layout of the components is very compact. ChargerLab found that this charger adopts the architecture of PFC and ACF.And the protocol chip can output wide range voltage under the control of optocoupler. The GaN-IC and planar transformer can make this charger smaller. Next, we will remove all the components and analyze them one by one. The specs of the time delay fuse is 3.15A 250 volts, and the safety X capacitor comes from STE. The blue varistor is used for overvoltage protection, and two common mode chokes are used to filter out EMI interference. This is a bridge rectifier. Those two film capacitors for filtering come from Carlis MPH series. The filter inductor is next to it. This is discharge chip of X capacitor, model is PN8201. The PFC boost controller comes from NXPTEA19162, used for boosting the rectified voltage and active PFC. It integrates discharge chip of X capacitor and can support soft startup and shutdown, high precision voltage regulation, etc. The PFC boost MOSFET comes from Oriental Semi OSG65R200JF and adopts PDFN8x8 package, 700 volts, 200 milliohm. The fast recovery diode comes from Hingwei PBMUR5JE and is used for PFC boost rectification. The PFC boost inductor is wrapped with copper foil and the plastic shell is used for reinforcement and protection. The electrolytic capacitor for high voltage filtering comes from Capaxon, 450 volts, 82 microfarad. The power supply capacitor of mass control chip also comes from Capaxon, 40 volts, 82 microfarad. A GaN chip marked with JW1551A. The GaN-IC adopts ST Master GaN 1, which integrates two GaN FETs and half bridge drivers. It can reduce the external components and make the PCB layout more compact. It adopts 9x9x1mm QFN package and working current is 10A, 650 volts, 150 milliohm. Those two optocouplers are used for feeding back output voltage. Those are two Y capacitors. The planar transformer is welded on the left side of the output and insulated by the plastic shell. The USB-C receptacle is welded on a small PCB. And there are two solid capacitors for output filtering on the right. The synchronous rectifier controller is marked with JWNRJ, and the synchronous rectifier adopts Infineon BSC093N15NS and Super S08 package, 150 volts, 9.3 milliohm. There is a row of MLCC capacitors on the secondary side for filtering. There is a WeBus switch on the front of the small output PCB, and a protocol chip is on the back. Model is CPS8841. It uses QFN 4x4 package and the input voltage is 3 to 22 volts. It supports multiple charging protocols such as USB PD3, BC1.2, QC2, etc. The Huawei Superfast Charging protocol is also added. There are two triodes. Output VBUS switch is marked with S418N. The USB-C receptacle is protected by plastic and steel. Well, this is the fourth generation of GaN charger from Huawei and supports two PBS PDLs. It also supports Huawei PCF SCP protocol additionally, so its compatibility is pretty good. If you're a Huawei user, this charger can almost charge all of your Huawei devices. The layout is very compact and GaN-IC can effectively reduce the external components. It also adopts a highly integrated planar transformer and is placed in the hull of PCB. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!